College students are constantly put into stressful situations. With exams, papers, and assignments, school starts to become a student's priority over health, motivation, and happiness. I'm here at Stanford over the summer for research, and I've just finished my third year at MIT, so I know all of this firsthand. In this video, along with taking you around my day as usual, I'm going to tell you that it's very possible to succeed and also stay happy and healthy in the process. Hey, I just got ready for the day, and I'm here just outside my dorm room. It's a beautiful day, so it's already a good start to the day. And right now we're just about to head to breakfast. I think today's gonna be a pretty exciting day. One of my more eventful days that I've vlogged so far, because I'm gonna have research, I'm gonna have an opportunity to work in the wind tunnel, and maybe also do something later today because it's Friday. So come along for the ride. Right now I'm heading to breakfast to get a quick bite to eat before I head over to lab. I didn't leave Timmy, he actually overslept, so I'm going to head over before it closes so I have a chance to eat. The first part of taking care of yourself is surrounding yourself with the people that have your best interest in mind. I have a group of people that I know that I can go to for just about anything, and I think that's really important. Because no matter what is going on with me at any given time, I know that I'm not alone. And just knowing that I have that safety net of people's support allows me to push myself further than I would have otherwise. On a similar note, don't forget about the people that have always unconditionally cared about you, your family. Regardless of how you're doing in school or how your life is going at any particular moment in time, your family will always be there for you because they just want you to be happy. One of the biggest things that I've learned is that if you talk out your problems with the people that actually care about you, you'll be able to come up with more rational solutions faster than you would have otherwise. So there's absolutely no reason that you should keep everything bottled up. That will just hurt you more, and in turn, the people that care about you as well. So right now I'm just going to head into lab. Usually I go in and just get settled and have a short conversation with the graduate student I'm working under, and just to see what we're going to be doing for the day. I think today's going to be pretty eventful. You'll see. So I just walked into lab and touched bases with the grad student, and turns out the physics shop is open right now. And the physics shop is a place on campus where researchers and students can go and get some supplies that they need, whether it's an Arduino, a wire, or some type of fitting. So I'm gonna go in right now because I have a part that I need, and I also need to pick up an Arduino, so let's head in there. So that was a successful trip. I got the things that I needed. Now it's time to head back to lab and see if I can make any of this work. Know your worth. Trust me, I know it's easy to just beat up on yourself for not being good enough, because I've done that a lot in the past. But remember that wherever you are in life right now, and whatever you've done or haven't done, you are, in your own respect, a special individual. Instead of focusing on the things that you lack, focus in on everything that you succeed in or provide to the people around you. Just like you'll be there for a friend when they're down to lift their spirits up, be there for yourself and lift your own spirits up when you're feeling down. It's totally normal to be self-critical, but you should also make it totally normal to be self-praising as well. So of course, when I finally sit down to start working, my laptop is discharged and I forgot my charger at home. So right now I'm heading back to my dorm and pick up my laptop charger.
So I got my charger, and that was actually more inconvenient than I thought it would be. My dorm is about half a mile away and a couple of flights of stairs also. So I'm actually just pretty tired. It's also got pretty hot, so I started sweating on the walk over because I'm trying not to miss that much time in lab, because I was actually pretty excited to sit down and actually start working on this Arduino. But now I'm heading back, so should be good the rest of the day. So I did make some progress in just game planning what I'm about to do, but I got hungry, so I'm about to head over with Timmy to just have some lunch. Find something you're passionate about that's non-academic. You've heard me say this many times, but I can't reiterate it enough. Playing basketball and staying fit gives me the opportunity to stop thinking about all of the stress involved with school and with my research. It's in those moments where I can just do something that I enjoy with a free mind. When I did have those times where I wasn't able to play basketball or go to the gym or just stay active, I wasn't as happy and it was noticeable. So now I make sure to just go play for a bit whenever I feel as if I'm not making any progress on the work that I'm working on. And then when I get back, I end up being more productive than I was before I left. So I make up for that time anyway. Now it's time to get back to work, and yeah, it's pretty cool because the thing about research is that it's so novel that this stuff hasn't been done before, so I'm trying to read a bunch of papers, go through different articles just to try to put different things together and make the system that I want to make. And that challenge really excites me and keeps me going and keeps me motivated to keep trying to learn more things. Coming back from lab right now, and I actually had a really great day after the whole forgot my charger incident. I was able to go to the 3D printer to print some extra parts that I needed, but I was also able to code my Arduino and have it so that keyboard input would vary how long my linear servo would become, and that's really the biggest challenge of my project, so I was really happy that came out well. Now I just made it back to my dorm, and I'm probably going to relax a little bit before dinner and just watch a show or two and see how it goes. Just like you schedule time for meetings and assignment due dates, schedule time for just you. Either on an actual calendar or just mentally in your head. Slot off, say, Saturday evening just to unwind and binge watch a show on Netflix, or just relax or take a nap. Having something to look forward to at the end of a stressful week will help keep you optimistic and motivated during the week. Even during weekends where I didn't technically have anything planned, I made sure to know to myself that I'm not going to do anything work-related Saturday evenings, that I'm just going to relax. This past semester, I got into a great groove where I can work extra hard for 4 out of the 7 days of the week in academics, spend a day or two for YouTube, and still have at least a day to just unwind. And because of this groove, I was able to sustain my success in YouTube, in my classes, and in my research. I postpone everything, worrying about stupid things, when it's my turn. Start living. Cause I remember growing up, we rode our bikes all over town, spending all our cash on candy bars. One of the of the many perks of this program is that all our meals are paid for. So for breakfast and dinner, we get meals in the dining hall. And even though the food isn't that great, it's still good to have a good variety of food and to just be able to fill up every time I have dinner or breakfast. As we get further along into this program, we're all getting more comfortable with each other. So dinner becomes a good chance to catch up and just have fun and relax and de-stress about school. And it's just always great. Everything is so damn hard, I'll work through it. I postpone everything. Worrying about stupid things. No more, no more. Cause I remember growing up, we rode our bikes all over town. Spending all our cash on candy bars. And no one ever told us that tomorrow it might not. So now we're heading back from the gym. We thought it closed an hour later, so we only ended up being there for 15 minutes, but it was still fun to shoot around, just de-stress for the day. Now we're heading back, and I really don't know what we're going to do. We might just watch some Netflix show or Hulu show. Don't really know yet, but yeah, we're heading back. I'ma keep my mind straight. I will never let them in. I will find my clarity. So tonight we really just chilled. We ended up just watching a show and just talking. It's actually chill nights like these where I really appreciate the type of people I surround myself with. And I think that's a big part of why I've been so successful for so long. Just having people that I can talk to and not feel pressure to do any specific thing and just enjoy myself is really something that I don't take lightly and I don't take for granted, because I really appreciate the people that are around me every day. So if there's one thing to take away from this video, it's just take care of yourself. You can be successful and be happy at the same time. You don't have to choose between one or the other. If you want a chance to be featured on one of my YouTube videos or on my Instagram story, go get some merch. I'll put the link down below. And I'm posting a lot more on my Instagram, so make sure you follow that to stay up to date with what I'm doing. As for this channel, I have a lot of really cool videos planned, and I'm trying to stick to this 2-video-a-week schedule. So make sure you subscribe and have the notification bell clicked for those. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.